So for my next project, I've got to work on this washing machine. The has a fault. It doesn't spin when it goes to the end of the cycle. So I go through the whole cycle, to the wash cycle and stuff like that. But when it comes to the spin section, the timer doesn't go down. It doesn't actually spin. It drains the water out and it's not blocked or anything like that. So that's usually the first thing you check for. But it doesn't spin. So I'm at a bit of a loss moment about what it is. So turn all this stuff here off, turn that off, leave that on spin. So it's got 11 minutes, 7 hours, I'll do 6:15, 9 minutes, okay. I'm gonna do this one and it will drain, which you can probably hear it doing. It's only supposed to do that for a short time and then it's supposed to go to spin. But it will sit here with 8 minutes left for the entire time. It won't actually come down and it will rotate, but it will never spin. So that's what I'm looking on right now, is trying to figure that bit out. And obviously it's problematic. Okay, so that's about as fast as it gets. It's probably going to prove me wrong now. But yeah. But I know you can hear it, but on the motor there, it's actually making an interesting sound. It's a clicking sound. So I'm actually suspecting there's a fault with the motor. It does have a test mode. So what I'll do is try and turn it on. I might not have enough fingers for this. It doesn't reach. Right, I'm going to try and do this. So I've told the power and the rinse, spin and power at the same time. That brings up the test mode. And then from there, each button press on the start button goes through one of the steps in the sequence. So that's just the slow spin or slow turning. Okay, so it's anti-clockwise slow turn. This is a low speed spin. So the motor seems to be capable of doing it. This one should be high speed spin. Get faster, ramp up. Then it's got some tests for the water inlets, so it's turning water inlets on, which I've currently got turned off. But it enables the inlet controls. And then at some point there's actually one which tries to turn the motor again. Yeah, that's it. So it should be trying to turn the motor here. So you can hear that buzzing. But it won't turn. If I give it a nudge. It still doesn't want to go. So something there is not right. If I give it a bit of a push, it might sometimes go. Not really. But the fact it's making a buzzing sound. Yeah, this makes you wonder about whether it's the motor or not. That's something else, I don't know what it is. And it's draining it out, which does work. So, it's off. So I'm a bit concerned whether it's the controller, which is just in here. or whether it's the motor itself, or whether it's something which senses the water levels. But unfortunately, the service manual found is not for this particular washer. It's similar, it's like a later model. This one's a 700 or LF700B, which is inside here. There you go, just here. So, the one I've actually found is for a 708, which is a little bit different. But it's got the same motor and similar. That's how I found out about this test menu on the front here, is by reading the menu. So the button's actually got, it's got a different button on it, but I found by doing those two there and the power button, that worked. So, and the steps aren't exactly the same as in the other unit, but they're similar. But there's some differences between the two units, but it's a bit of a pain, but trying to figure it out. I mean, the electrolytic capacitors on that control board look fine. There's a power supply board there where the main power comes in. I'm not sure if it's a fault with the motor, because it is clicking, which makes you wonder if there's a fault with the motor, or if it's a fault with the control board. I'm not sure which one it is. So I've already pre-loosened these bolts here. I can't be bothered going to the garage to get my socket set out, so I'm just gonna do it by hand. I'm probably undoing the right bolts. This electrical connection here, which I've got to get off, I can't see how it comes off yet, so I'm gonna have to do that off or take the motor off. I really hope that's the right connection. Obviously I've turned the power off to this now. It's not even plugged in. So it's all gonna be a little bit awkward, I'm sure. Feels like it's screwing into like a washer in the back. Yeah, sure enough. There it is. Alright. Which I've now lost. Where'd it go? There it is. Alright. So it's screwed into this. Same for the other one. Which makes it a bit easier, just spin the washer around on the back. That's pretty cool. I'm not quite sure, I can't just use a nut, but there you go. There's the other one. Let's just get this belt off. Side drive it. There you go. Belt off. Give it a push. Apparently it pushes backwards. Apparently. Yeah, of course it's not going to move. Why would it move? Oh man. Is there more? I would have expected more bolts than that. It's a fair amount of finding the else. The manual would have said about the two at the front, and that's all I can see. It's probably just a little bit stuck. Let's just get something to give it a tap with. Hold on. Let's just try this in case it's heavy enough. It ain't going anywhere, is it? Let's check if anything anywhere else. Can't feel anything anywhere else. Pretty sure it just wedges onto these mounts here, because the manual mentioned just those two bolts there pushing it backwards, but it doesn't want to push back, so I might stop, pause this for a minute while I sort this out. All right, so the it's the motor here. So first thing we've got is these brushes, to see what kind of condition they're in, because they could well be worn out. And the other thing I'll look at is this on the end of the shaft here, will be a Hall effect sensor inside here. That could also be faulty. It's possible. So it is clicking when it turns, so I'm going to take the brushes out and spin it and see if it still clicks. If it doesn't click, then the brushes will be causing the clicking. And then it may just be that they're worn out and they're replacing. So it could even be there's some kind of issue with that causing a sensing problem. So let's grab a screwdriver and pull those off. Start with this one. Let's hope I don't drop it into the motor, that would be bad. So I had a quick look online for a new motor for this in case the motor is dodgy, and it's $400 Australian, so don't want to go there. Okay, so that popped out a long way, so there's still heaps of travel on those brushes. So the brush looks alright. At least as far as travel goes. The other one should be the same, I expect. Seems a bit sticky. Yeah, interesting. So the travel on this one? Much shorter than the other one. So you can get them side by side, there you go. So one side's worn out more than the other. But it's still got enough travel on it to be okay. It's not worn out yet. It's getting close, but it's not there yet. So I'm actually wondering if I should swap them around. If one side's wearing more than the other. Might give it some more life. So, okay, now they're out. Lay this down. A little bit of bearing noise, not much, and no ticking. So the ticking's also just for those brushes. It's maybe a little bit loose or something, and they're in their bushes. So there's a motor information there, part number. So yeah, I might actually unclip these brushes and swap them around. Sort of balancing here on the end of the bloody shaft, but figure out how it seems clipped in. I can look at that at least. Here we go. Okay. Pulls up. Right. Okay. So yeah. So I swap these around. I think they're both the same. They they look the same, but you can see the difference in wear. Which is why I'm going to swap it around. They look identical, so hopefully this will help even out the wear. Now, just a chance of dropping him into the motor. There's that clicking again. That's always just the brushes on that. That shaft there. Alright. So I guess the clicking is nothing to worry about then, because it's just the brushes wearing. The next question is this piece. It's got a sensor in the end here. I just don't know if it's working. Next question is how do I get that part? Press disc down here, which has got his fingers on it, to wedge it in. Not meant to come apart, is it? Eh? Hate when they do stuff like that. Here we go. Right. Now what? That's the shaft. So that's sitting around under the shaft. And it's got again little fingers in it to hold it in place. I think I need to try and get in behind that and lever it a little bit. If I'm going to open it up, it's probably just a Hall effect sensor in there. That's probably all it is. I can actually see little slots in here. That might be fine anyway. But that could be what's wrong with it, who knows. As a test, I suppose I can check the winding resistances. If I knew which winding is which. I'm not exactly a motor expert, and I know very little about them. So, I did this weird thing in the manual about. Testing these terminals, so I shall just pull that back up on my computer and I'll come back and have a look. Right, so what I've done here is I've fired those two wires down from that sensor on the back, which is because there's only two wires, it's probably not a Hall effect sensor, it's probably more like a reed switch or something. So I'm going to probe onto those. And I've got it hooked up to my meter in continuity test. And as I turn the shaft, but sensing the positions. Seems fairly consistent, so I think that sensor on the back's okay. It's got all these other wire connections here for the motor, so I'll now ignore those two. This one here is one of the brushes. So that brown one there is one of the brushes. And there's a black wire on the other side, which I think is probably this one here, which is another brush, which leaves five wires. I've got no idea how these things work. Anyway, there was a mention of resistance measurements for the motor in the manual I've got, but the manual is actually for a different machine and it's got a different motor in it, different connections, so I can't actually use that as a reference. I've just tried probing around but can't find anything which actually matches up. Alright, so I put the motor back in, and as you can hear, it's running and it sounds very different. Clicking that whir, and it is actually spinning now, as you can see, hopefully. And the timer's coming down, which before that wasn't happening. So it looks like it was an issue with the motor. I'm wondering if just those brushes being a bit dodgy, and so it wasn't working properly. Maybe it wasn't using all the windings or something. So, hopefully that's that fixed.